Hello little scientists, welcome to ALLEN IntelliBrain. We all have seen big chimneys of factories and power plants which release the smoke and other gases out of the plant. But do you know how they work? In this video, we will make a small model and understand how the chimneys function. From the Intelli SMART Box, take out the Heat and Convection Activity kit. From the kit, take out the chimney effect model parts, the tea light candle and the dhupatti. The chimney effect model parts include the front plate W, the side plates L and R, the black plate, the top plate T, a transparent OHP sheet, two transparent chimney prints A and B, two sticky foam rings, four foam rings and eight O-rings. You will also need a matchbox from your home. Since we are performing this activity using fire and flammable objects, always keep some water handy to prevent your surroundings from catching fire. Also, perform it under adult supervision. First of all, take the black plate and the side plates L and R. Insert the extended bits of L and R into the black plate. L to the left and R to the right. Now secure them with O-rings. Take the top plate T and insert the extended bits into the black plate. Here. We have to keep this side with the multiple cuts on the right. Again, secure the extended bits with the O-rings. Now, take the transparent OHP sheet and the front plate W. Can you see these slits in the transparent sheet? Insert these on the remaining extended bits of plates T, L and R, like this. Now, see, there are similar slits in the front plate W also. Insert these on the extended bits and secure the two plates with O-rings. Now, take the sticky foam rings and peel off the tapes. Then, stick them on these two circular cuts on the top plate. Let's take the chimney prints now. We'll start with the one marked A. Cut the sheet along this black marked outline. Roll this sheet into a cylinder such that it fits into the foam rings. We can try inserting it into the foam rings to check this. Mount two foam rings on it like this. Repeat the same for chimney print B. Cut along the line. Roll into a cylinder and mount two foam rings on it. Now, fix these two cylinders A and B into the sticky foam rings that we had stuck on the top plate. Make sure that the cylinder A is towards the left and the cylinder B is towards the right. They will work as the inlet and outlet chimneys. Your model is now ready. Now, light up the tea light candle with the help of a matchstick and place it on a flat surface. You can take the help of an adult for this. Place the chimney effect model over the candle such that the candle is under the chimney A. Like this. Now, let's light up the dhoop batti using the matchstick. Blow it off after 10 seconds. Like this. Be careful with the matchstick and do this under adult supervision only. Now, remove the chimney B and keep the dhoop batti on the marked central circle. Like this. And now, fix the chimney back into the foam ring. Wait for a few seconds and observe what happens. When the air above the candle is heated, it expands. This expanded air is less dense than the surrounding air and thus rises out of chimney A. As the air inside the box is completely pulled out of the chimney, the smoke from the dhoop batti rushes inside the box to fill it. When the smoke is again heated by the candle, it is pulled out of chimney A. In this way, chimney B serves as the inlet of air and chimney A serves as the outlet of air. And hence, we are able to observe the chimney effect. All this happens due to the convection current. Convection currents cause fluids to move from high temperature to low temperature. This movement of fluids helps in the transfer of heat from one point to another in case of many natural phenomena. Visualize science with IntelliBrain and fall in love with learning.